So today we are going to draw respiratory epithelium, which is pseudostatic persiliated columnar epithelia with corpuscles. So we have to draw the basement membrane first. So this is the basement membrane. Now over this you have to draw the cells. So pseudostatified columnar epithelia, ciliated columnar epithelia, consists of many cells. So we have drawn tall cell, now this short cell, again a tall cell. So again a short cell, a tall cell. So this is how we should draw. And there is one more thing here, there are goblet cells. So this is how goblet cells looks. So you can draw according to this. Yeah, it looks like a wine glass. And now a short cell and a long cell has been drawn. Again, yeah, this way. Again a short cell, again a long cell. This is how we should draw. Now, what is the meaning of pseudostratified epithelium? Pseudostratified epithelium is an epithelium which is false stratification, which is meaning false stratification. That means usually the stratified epithelium, the basement membrane, we draw the basement membrane, then we draw the cells. Stratified epithelium in the sense we have many layers. So the first cells, the basal cells, will touch the basement membrane. Whereas other cells will not touch the basement membrane, cells which are above the basal cells. So that is called by stratified, or that is the meaning of stratification. So you have many layers. But here, the basal cells, I mean the cells, all the cells here, what we've drawn here, are touching the basement membrane. You can see here the tall cells, the short cells, the goblet cells, they are touching the basement membrane. Okay, so it's actually a simple epithelium. The definition of simple epithelium is actually all the cells should touch the basement membrane. Here the cells are touching the basement membrane, but it looks like a stratified epithelium. How it is possible? That is because of the nucleus arrangement, how the nucleus is arranged in the cells. So because of that, it looks as that of a stratified epithelium. That means many layered epithelium. But actually they are simple epithelium. So let's see how to draw the nucleus here. So when we draw the nucleus here in this, we need to be very specific. Here the tall cells, you can see that tall cells nucleus is at the top level, the upper level, where the short cells nucleus is at the lower level. So you can see that here, tall cells and the short cell, how the nucleus is put. The goblet cells, again it is at the base, because goblet cells produce the mucus. So the mucus is pushing the nucleus downwards. Here you can see again the nucleus, how it is put in different levels. So in the microscope it looks as that of a stratified epithelium, but actually it is a simple epithelium. That is why the name is given as pseudo stratified columnar epithelium. Now we have one more thing here, they are cilia. We will draw the cilia after finishing this. So let's complete the nucleus, how to put the nucleus. Again, see the goblet cells nucleus, where it is put, it's in the basal level. Different level nucleus can be seen in this. The goblet cells, again the short cell, see that here, yes. Now let's put the cilia. Now cilia are motile organelles. Actually they are cell surface projections. You can see when we draw the cilia, we are supposed to draw on the cells, not on the goblet cells. So goblet cells are not having any cilia, so you can leave that place there as empty. So this is how it looks. So this epithelium lines the respiratory tract, majority of the respiratory tract. So it is called as a respiratory epithelium. You can see the cilia there, they are the microtubules, cilia. I hope you have understood. You can see that. Okay, thank you.